Welcome back to the channel. In today's video, I'm going to be covering the Tesmen AC Non-Contact Voltage Detector, the TN213, and the Tesmen Smart Digital Multimeter, the TM510. I'll do a little basic unboxing, cover a few specifications, and explain what these things are used for, and demonstrate how to use them also. Okay, before I get started with the unboxing here, I just wanted to thank Tesmen for sending these out for my review. Okay, so let's get started with the Tesmen Non-Contact TN213 detector here. Now, I actually opened these a few minutes ago and put the batteries in. I just wanted to show you what's in the box here. So we have a little owner's manual. They do have English in there. And one thing cool about this, I thought, was that instead of sending like really cheap, no-name batteries you've never heard of, they actually put Duracell batteries in here. I thought that was nice. And we'll just turn it on before we get started. But I'm going to actually cover the multimeter next unboxing. Let's turn it off for now. And now for the TM510 multimeter. Now this one doesn't have the amp clamps like you see in other ones. I have one of those too. User's manual. A nice little bag to house everything, keep things from being losing things. So here are the probes. We'll plug in just a second. Again, it came with Duracell batteries. I'll have to put those in. And it comes with this little green protective sleeve. And here's where the batteries, you just take this little screw and put the batteries in. I'll do that off camera in just a second. And let's see, the probes, there's a little protective piece there to keep you from damaging the inside of this, these little plugs here. So these plug in, and it also has, I think I mentioned earlier, a non-contact AC voltage detector here. It's built in right here, and you can actually put it up. It's the same as this tip on there, but it's built inside here. I'll go through the details on how to do that in a minute. Let me put the batteries in, and then I'll come back and do a little testing. So first, I've decided to talk about the TN213 no contact voltage tester. So what is a non-contact voltage tester? NCV for short is acronym they use for these things. Typically you find these in the toolbox of a homeowner instead of more professional. Professionals like electricians use multimeters more, but a lot of homeowners have these. If you go to a big box hardware store, you'll find a variety of these for sale. So what do you do with these things? Well, you use them to test if there is AC voltage in like a live wire, an outlet, a variety of things you could test to see if there's AC voltage present. You could try to see like if there's a break in the wire. You can run this along the wire and determine where the break is, and then you might want to cut it there and then fix it. You know, of course, if there's no electricity. You could maybe be working in a wall and you find a wire and you're thinking, what is this wire? I have no idea. You could check first, see if it's live, and then you could maybe go turn the breakers on and off one at a time until it goes off. So you know which breaker that wire goes to. There's a variety of things you can use these things for. One warning I will tell you about, it says right here on the side, if I can get that to focus, it says always test known live circuit before use. And what that means is, let's just do it. Test something else. And first we want to know, is this thing working? That's basically what that warning is. So we check it. It's working. Then you can test what you want to test. So you put it, you first hit something live, you know, is working, is live. And then you can use this test on it. Next, let's talk about the IP66 waterproof rating. What does that mean? That just means it can withstand spraying from a hard jet of water, but it cannot be submerged. There's an O-ring. I don't know if you saw it earlier when I showed the batteries. There's an O-ring right here to keep out dust and water, so you can't submerge these. This one is green. It comes in red or blue. Let's talk about the buttons here. So we have two buttons. We have the power button. And long press to turn it off, and then we have a sensitivity mode or flashlight. So let's turn on the flash. Okay, I just switched this. A single press changes sensitivity mode. Let's see if I can get that in there and focus. Maybe. There it is. Switching between 12 volt and 1,000 volts and stay in focus there. And 70 volts, which is low sensitivity. That's high sensitivity, low sensitivity. And if you hold it, that button, it turns on the flashlight. Not a bright one, but it would work in a pinch. Hold the button and it turns it off. This auto shuts off in 5 minutes if it's not being used. So this little LCD screen here, you don't normally see those. If you, some of the big brand names, Klein, Fluke, things like that, they don't have LCD screens, or at least the ones that I've seen. There may be others, but they don't have these little LCD screens. So that's a nice feature. And there's a right above the AC there will be a low battery warning when the batteries start to run out. So let's talk about the low sensitivity again. So the low sensitivity is probably going to be too sensitive in most cases. And I'll show you that when I demonstrate it in a minute. And that's going to be, for most cases, useful for what you're looking for. So it's the percentage right here at the bottom, that is the percentage of strength of the voltage it's detecting. So as you move closer, it may be detecting more and more voltage as you get closer to it with this probe at the end. So that percentage will go up. Like you could be right on top of the wire and that may go to 100. So let's do a little testing here. So right now we are in low sensitivity mode. So let's test an outlet here. So first I'll show you, I'll run it up and down, nothing. I stick it, if you remember, the big slot is the neutral wire and the smaller one is the live wire. So if I stick this in the neutral, nothing. If I stick it in the hot, you get a beep and a red blinking light. Now, one interesting thing, if I switch this to high sensitivity, you'll see what I mean here when I was explaining. You may have to switch back and forth, but you can just get close to this. You don't even have to go into the live wire slot, and it detects AC voltage. Let's see. Now, if I stick it in there, it goes to, as you can see, 75. It's an annoying beep, but you may need it to be to hear it. So another thing you can test this with is actual wire. Now let's switch to low sensitivity. Let's just see if it picks it up. So one thing you can do is let's go around the wire. Okay, that's not detecting anything in low sensitivity. Now if I switch it to high sensitivity, it's detecting voltage in that wire. And let's see what else. So it's got if you want to put it in the pocket of your shirt or something, or your pants pocket and hold it in there, that's a little clip for that. And I believe I have covered this completely. I've only tested this for a day or two, just a little bit here and there, and it seems to work pretty well. I did put it in the outlet of an extension cord once, and it didn't detect on a low sensitivity. It didn't detect voltage when there was voltage. I put it in high sensitivity and it worked. So my recommendation would be, if you test something and it shows no voltage in low sensitivity, switch it to high sensitivity just to make sure. That's my recommendation. So as I mentioned, I've been testing this for a couple of days, and so as far as I can tell, this is a good unit. The Amazon rankings is 4.5 stars out of 5, so that tells me with pretty good confidence that this is probably a good unit to have. So now I wanted to talk about the Tesmen TM510. So, as I think I covered earlier, this is a green sleeve. It also comes in red and blue, the sleeve. And I installed the probes earlier, and I think I mentioned that these little pieces come in here for protection, but it's probably more from dust than anything, protecting, getting dust down in these things and making them not work as good over time. So let's start here. So first, I mentioned this earlier, but this also has, as the TN213, has no contact voltage testing. This also has that feature. Let me just start with that. I hit the power button to turn it on. So the sensor is right here. So to test, you would just put it up close to something. Oh, to enable that feature, you have to hold down the NCV button here. Okay, now it's doing no contact voltage testing. So put it up close. And you saw it went up, it got it there, but I think it's more went for like wires and things. You can see it's working on the wire here. So it has that feature. But how this is basically different from the other one is, other than the no contact, is that it takes physical contact to test things. And you can test DC voltage, AC voltage, up to 600 volts total. If you go over 600 volts, it would definitely destroy this unit. Let's go through some of the buttons here. So this is a backlight display to help you see it. Or if you hold the button, there is a flashlight on this unit too. Again, not real strong, but enough to see in the dark. So this is used to test voltage, resistance, and continuity. So we'll go through those tests in a minute. If you notice, it says auto. So that's what makes this different, is it's stepping through these different functions. You don't have to turn a switch to tell it what you're trying to do. It knows what you're trying to do, and it will tell you that information. Okay, so I'll start testing AC voltage here. So if you remember, the small hole is for the live wire. So we'll start negative, positive, and if it focuses, it's showing you it selected that first option on the top left, and then it's 121.2 volts AC voltage. Now let me test a DC source. Okay, to show a DC voltage test, I had to rig this up here where I just kind of tightened these slightly down on the probes so I could show you a DC test. So it says DC there, and we have 13.59 volts. So one other thing we can test is what they call continuity. So it's going through its auto cycling, looking for what to do. So continuity is basically when it flows through from this probe to this probe without interruption. So that's how you test that continuity is going to work. So one test here would be this wire. So I suspect maybe if this wire has a break, so let's test. I could put one in here and one in here. There is continuity, so it flows through all the way. Another test would be like this fuse. Now this fuse is something I blew while testing some DIY solar stuff. So let's check to see if it's blown. But first I'll check just right here on this plate so you can see there's continuity definitely right here between these two. As there is. But will it flow through the whole fuse? That means if it won't, it's blown. And I know it's blown. So there's no continuity at all. So that means that fuse is blown. That's one thing you can test, continuity. The other is resistance. I don't have a lot of experience with testing resistance, but this is a 10 watt 5 ohm resistor that I've bent the ends to kind of hold this for this test. So this is 5 ohms. I have another multimeter I tested. I turned it to the ohm and it showed 5 or close to 5. Let's see what this one does. You know, I don't have a lot of experience, so let's see. It looks like it's settling in 0.007. And earlier I saw 5 and 6 and 7, so let's get it up here, see if I can hold it. So it's got that K right above the resistance. The ohms indicator right there, it showed a K. And I think that's in 1,000. So if you take the reading that had, 0.007, and times that times 1,000, that's 7 ohms of resistance. Now, earlier, let me see if I switch it the other way, if it's any different. Positive on the other side. Okay, I don't know if you can see that, but it showed 0.005, and that would be 4, 3, 4. So it moves around there. It's not, and like I say, I don't have a lot of experience, so maybe you should pay attention to what I say about this. But that's, and that K I think is 1,000, which I think it comes out to be, you just times that times 1,000, and that would be the number of ohms of resistance that you're getting with this test. Hey, and if you know better than me, and I'm sure you do, please put down in the comments the proper way to do that test. So what do I think about the 10213 and the TM510 multimeter. I like both of them. I think they both have a place in a homeowner's toolbox. Now, if you are solely doing DIY solar stuff, you may want to look at getting the one, the type that has the clamp that measures current or amperage. This one does. This model doesn't do that. This is more for your normal homeowner to do work around the house, check if something's live. There's a little bit of overlap here. This does non-contact voltage and testing only, and so does this. So why would you want to get this one? Well, I think mainly because it's smaller and slimmer. You can stick it in your pocket easy. As you can see, this requires quite a bit around. It's got a carry bag and things, so that if that may be just more convenient to carry this around, if that's all you needed to do. If you need to do contact testing like this and do other functions, then you definitely would want the multimeter. And as far as price, these are, I guess you'd call budget friendly. These are much less costly as some of the big name brands with much less features. Like I said, the big name ones, I think, are like four times the cost of these. And at the time of me filming this, it just happens to be a few days before Black Friday, and these are marked down even further right now. So I'll put the links down below, and you can go check out these and see what you think. So I hope you enjoyed watching this review of these products here. I didn't really know what this did that much. I've learned a lot doing this review. I've learned more about multimeters by doing this review. I hope you enjoyed it. Please like this video if you enjoyed it, and thanks for watching.